how the human life and the human family life and the world is very complicated. On the other hand, we find the world is led by the evil forces. Yesterday, a servant of God, today he becomes an animal, a behavior of animal. Filled with the Holy Spirit, David kills Goliath. The next moment, when he saw Saul's daughter, don't know what happened. Maybe, don't know what happened. When he saw her, he became mad. And people take advantage of your madness. If you are falling in love with somebody, people will take all kinds of advantage on you. Now Saul says, you want to marry my daughter? Then you should bring the skin of 100 Philistines. Saul thought, by killing 100 people, at least one fellow will kill David. But this mad fellow, mad after that girl. He said, I want that girl by all means. Not 100, I will bring 200. Mad. A man filled with the Holy Spirit. You become, who will do like that? Killing the human beings, peeling the skin, who will do? What action? Is it the action of the Holy Spirit or evil spirit? He does. Yesterday, filled with the Holy Spirit. Today, not alert to take care of the Holy Spirit. So the evil spirit took over him. Like a mad fellow, he went and killed 200 people. Some are alive. He peeled them and brought and took the girl. If you take something which God has not given to you, you will lose it with the pain. If God has given you something, nobody can take it away from you. But if you are trying to take something forcefully, which God has not kept for you or designed for you, you will lose it with the pain. And the lady went away from him, made the life of David miserable one. Yes. A man filled with the Holy Spirit, next moment filled with the evil spirit. We read in the book of Matthew chapter 16, where the Lord Jesus asked Peter, what do you think about the Son of Man? Everybody said, you are a prophet, you are this and that. Peter said, Lord, you are the living God. You are the savior of the world. Jesus said, Shabash, your answer has come from the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has inspired you. So Peter was flying in the air. Jesus not only said that, Peter, you are a rock. Upon you I will build my rock, build my church. Was so happy. Then Jesus speaks about his death. The Son of Man has to die. Few minutes ago, he got a certificate. The Holy Spirit is leading him. When Jesus spoke about death, immediately he says, Jesus, come. You made me leader now. Now you should listen to me. Don't talk about death, cross. What is this? Jesus said to her, get behind me, Satan. Few minutes ago, Holy Spirit led him. Within few minutes, Satan is leading him. This is the very precarious situation of the humankind. The humankind don't hunger for the Holy Spirit. They want to get it freely. I should go for the retreat and somebody should pray over me and I should get the Holy Spirit and I will live with. It's not like that. Holy Spirit is a gift given to us, it's true. But if he has to be with us, we have to nurture him with great care and compassion, great care and love. He's a human, like a person, he's a person. Holy Spirit is not that something you ate yesterday, biryani, and today also biryani will be there. No. Every day, you have to work to be in the companionship of the Holy Spirit. So, you need to learn 6 important truths. Number 1, we read in St. John's Gospel, chapter 16, verse 5 onwards, I am going to the Father who sent me, yet none of you ask me, where are you going? But because I have said these things, sorrow has filled your hearts. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. What is the truth Jesus wants to tell them? He tells them, it is to your advantage. It is to your advantage that I go. For if I do not go away, the advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him that he may be with you. So here Jesus says, Holy Spirit is what Jesus gives to all of us as a precious gift. He says, I will go to my Father and send the Spirit to be with you. I can't be always with you, he says. Because he was in Palestine. How many people he can meet? If he says the whole over world, I'm Jesus, please come to meet me. What will happen? There won't be any hotels in Jerusalem. Full of hotels only. Even then we may not get appointment to meet the Lord. So Jesus, who walked in the place of Palestine, he can't meet everybody. So what does he do? He, after the death, being risen, Jesus says, I will go to my Father, and my Father will send same Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are same. So he will come, Jesus will come in the form of Holy Spirit. I will return back to you. That is the meaning. Then you will be witness to me, not only in Jerusalem, not only in Judah, all over the world. Wherever people are hungering for the Holy Spirit, all of them will receive. Praise the Lord. So the Holy Spirit, the world is a complicated world. The world is guided by the evil spirit. Evil spirit is roaring like a lion. Whom I can catch? Whom I can destroy? So in this world, to protect you, to save you, we need the Holy Spirit. And to receive that Holy Spirit, number one, we should know, to my complicated life, to the life which is led by the evil spirit, the answer of Jesus Christ is, I will not leave you orphan. I will ask my Father for the Holy Spirit to be with you as a companion. You look at the human life. When the child was born, God gives the gift of the mother. The mother takes the baby and feeds the baby and gives the milk of her, whereby the child grows. As the child grows, God raises up the father who works hard and earns the money and feeds the child. And when the child grows, the Lord arranges a companion to marry the child. And when they grow, God gives them the children to take care of them when they are old. This is the way the Lord creates. Now, here one more thing he says. This is for your life. A companion is from your birth to death. God has given for your family, for your physical life, God has given you a companion. In the same way, you have also a spiritual life. In your spiritual life, you are good. Suddenly, you become a weak man. Suddenly, you get an angry woman. Suddenly, you become a lustful fellow. So, you need to be kindly, spiritually built up. So, what is the answer? A companion has to be with you, to protect you, to guide you, to lead you, not to fall. When the child is about to fall, the mother goes and catches the child. When the son is not able to study, the father says, "Don't worry, I will take debt and I will educate you." So in the world, God gives somebody to build up our life. In the same way, for our spiritual life, somebody God gives to us. That's why he says, "I will go and send my spirit who will be with you and who will be in you."